quality is, you know, to anyone who has been around, is to a degree alarming. But again, I don't wish him harm. He's got people around him that have been able to keep him, generally speaking, in the middle of the road. The
right.
tweets, especially as it relates to foreign policy issues,
yeah.
I know have been very damaging to
yeah.
us, okay?
Yeah.
And I do wish that would stop. But, you know, as evidenced this morning, he just, it's just something he has to do.
Republicans
warning that he's, sometimes I feel like he's on a reality show of some kind, you
yeah.
know, when he's talking about these big foreign policy issues. And,
yeah.
And, you know, he doesn't realize that, you know, that we could be heading towards World War III with
yeah.
the kind of comments that he's making. And it's like it's an act of him, and sure, that bothers me.
Republican Bob Corker slamming President Trump to the New York Times. Wasn't that nice of him? Meanwhile, Corker is set to retire at the end of his term, but former White House Chief Strategist Steve Bannon is now launching a new effort to target other anti-Trump Republicans with plans to back primary opponents to nearly every Republican up for re-election. Think Alabama, Roy Moore. He joins us now. He's the executive chairman of Breitbart News. How are you?
How you doing?
You lost weight since you left the White House. You look good.
12 pounds.
Oh, good for you.
I feel great.
He's so arrogant. He's such an elitist snob. He's the swamp. The Senate hasn't done a thing, Steve. Nothing.
The American people see right here. This is what they think about President Trump behind closed doors. He happened to tell the New York Times exactly what I thought. It's totally unacceptable. In a time of war, we have troops in Afghanistan, in the Northwest Pacific and Korea. We have a major problem that could be like World War I, in the South China Sea, in the Persian Gulf. We have American lives at risk every day. He tweets on Sunday that it's like the adult center and somebody didn't have the morning shift, and then he has the audacity to go to the New York Times and to give this
type. He didn't know that was going to air. He didn't know they were going to release that.
I think, by the way, I'm not sure that he knew it was going to be a tape, but he gave those guys an on-the-record interview. You saw that in the New York Times. And by the way, Phil Rucker, yesterday in the Washington Post, the buried lead was, he said, there's only two or three senators on Capitol Hill that have President Trump's back. When you want to talk about why there's no repeal and replace, why there's no tax cut, why there's no tax reform, why there's no infrastructure bill, you saw it right there. Corker, McConnell, and Corker, and the entire clique, establishment globalist clique on Capitol Hill, have to go. And if we need any more proof about what they think, you heard it tonight, it's an absolute disgrace.
I've been told by people in the room, Ben Sasse, John McCain, Lindsey Graham, Corker, and even McConnell, they trash the president, but yet they can't get any of their promises completed. They are the swamp. Republicans are weak and pathetic, and they're lacking in identity. And the forgotten men and women that voted this election are being let down.
Look, they have total contempt for the forgotten man. They have total contempt for the base. That's what you saw in Alabama. In Alabama, where they came in with Luther Strange with $32 million to destroy Judge Moore, you saw at the base thought of them, right? The base totally rejected
them.
These people have no respect for the working men and women in the United States. And I tell you what, Senator Corker is an absolute disgrace. And I agree with Jason Miller, who is the comms director on our campaign. I think one of the best comms people around. Jason's on CNN, but he never talks out of school.
So sorry to hear that.
On CNN today, he called for Senator Corker to resign.
I agree with him.
For the governor of Tennessee to replace him with Marsha Blackburn, a real conservative. If Bob Corker has any honor, any decency, he should resign immediately. He should not let those words stand away. He said about the president.
He wouldn't win, Steve. That's why he's really getting out.
By the way, he got out because he saw what happened in Alabama. If he wants to, by the way, he should get back in because he's going to get crushed in a primary.
Marsha Blackburn would kill him.
He's going to get crushed in a primary. He doesn't have the guts to get in. So he doesn't have the guts to get back in the race. He should resign
immediately. All right, here's a question. How does the president's agenda, if he's got hostile Republicans that are apparently willing to go on a suicide mission, if they don't get anything accomplished, they don't get the budget done, they can't repeal and replace, they don't even want to fund the border wall. If they don't do those things, they're going to suffer in 2018. President Trump's not up till 2020.
They have to understand, there's a basic agenda that President Trump ran on and won. He carried states that Republicans haven't carried in living memory. Michigan, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania. This agenda works. The American people voted for it. It's their responsibility. By the way, McConnell would not be majority leader unless Trump in North Carolina, in Missouri, in Wisconsin was able to carry those senators across the finish line. It is incumbent upon them to back President Trump's plan, but you don't see it. What you saw with Corker said today is what they talk about on Capitol Hill. That's when I left the White House. Remember, I said, I'm going after the Republican establishment, and we're going to go after them. We're going to challenge. There's a coalition coming
together. Give me the states.
There's a coalition coming together that's going to challenge every Republican incumbent except for Ted Cruz, whether it's Utah, Wyoming, whether it's in
Orrin Hatch in Utah.
Orrin Hatch in Utah. Today, Boyd Matheson, who is the chief of staff for Mike Lee, came out and said that he's going to set up an exploratory committee.
North Dakota,
we don't have it. That's a Hobbs right. camp. But we're going. By the way, we're going in Mississippi against Wicker.
Who you pick? McDaniel.
McDaniel in Mississippi. These names are all going to come out over the next couple of weeks. There's going to be about
15. Not going to be. I know a lot of people didn't like in 2010, for example, Delaware. Well, I thought Christine O'Donnell was a nice woman. But you're picking rock-solid, credentialed candidates.
We're spending a ton of time with the grassroots organizations to make sure that these candidates are fully vetted. You're going to see people announced this week that are going to have experience in government. You're going to see some outsiders that are authentic, and these people are real. It's not like 2010. 2010 was the beginning of the Tea Party when things were first getting going. You're going to see real candidates, and by the way, they're going to take on incumbents in every state, and they're going to take on the Democrats after
that.
You
said in the 60 Minutes interview, you're a street fighter. I'm a street fighter, too.
I noticed that.
Okay. You noticed that? I'm not supporting any Republican incumbent that hasn't gotten their job done. Not one, Steve. I refuse. They have betrayed the American people. They have betrayed their promises. How do you make a promise for 7.5 years and not fulfill it?
It's a lack of sense of urgency. By the way, these guys work 3 days a week. The American people, now people are working two jobs. Their wives are working two jobs. They know the urgency out there on the economic hate crimes that have been perpetuated on the American working men and women in this country because of the trade deals.
Is this a fair statement? Is Steve Bannon declaring war on the establishment that are not for the working men and women in this country?
100%. We are declaring war on the Republican establishment that does not back the agenda that Donald Trump ran on and the President of the United States. And that is an agenda that we know backs the working men and women in this country.
This is basically a war because you know what McConnell did in Alabama. And you know there are people out there. Look,
Karl Rove is going to put in all their money. Karl Rove, Stephen Law, these guys should get the joke. Their donors are coming to us because they're tired of having their money burned up by trying to destroy people like Judge Moore. It's a new game in town. We're going to cut off the oxygen to Mitch McConnell. Mitch McConnell's biggest asset is the money. We're going to make it the biggest liability.
We're going
after these guys tooth and nail.
Does that mean that people that voted in 2010 and 2014 and 2016, now they have to wait to a victory in 2018? Listen, that's a long time for the American people to wait.
To take your country back, it's not going to happen in just any one election. This is something you're going to have to grind out day in and day out for the next 5, 10, 15, 20 years. It took us a long time to get here. There's no magic wand we can wave and drain the swamp. There's no magic wand we can wave and blow up this establishment. I hate to tell people you're going to have to work. But you know what? The grit, determination, and courage of the American working men and women, we're going to win.
I'm glad you're not going after Cruz. I've already endorsed him. And I'll tell you why.
Ted Cruz is a good man.
Ted Cruz has one of the few that he stood there and said, we have the constitutional authority to not fund Obamacare. And his own party betrayed him.
They're good men. I got to tell you, we are even safe incumbents like Barrasso and Deb Fischer, they have to understand something. Just voting is not good enough. You have to have a sense of urgency. Nobody's safe. We're coming after all of them, and we're going to win.
Street fighter Steve Bannon. Good to see you.